Hey guys. Miss my GoPro's working. Cool. Hey guys, it's Retoscape. This is a new series of on my channel, hopefully. This is Tektopia with these awesome people. This is my village. So this is my town hall. Here is my underground tree farm with my crops. We have a library, we have an inn. This is an empty room because I didn't quite do my math properly. Storage room here. This is the library, of course. This is next to the tavern. I'll probably put a ceiling in later. Yeah, this is an empty room. I'm not quite sure what to put in here. If you guys have any suggestions, then leave it in the comments. This is the butcher's. So I need cows and chickens, but it's a long way down from the surface to get here. This is why these doors are too wide. Because you can get a boat from the gap and they're open. This is the school. I'm working on carpeting where the lights up, and then probably the carpet on the floor rather than stone bricks. You've got the kitchen and the blacksmith. So, blacksmith here, kitchen here. The storage room is here. I wasn't aware that they've changed the way that it does the chest check. So I'm using single chests at the moment. I'm going to be changing that to double chests and filling the room as much as possible sensibly, but so it looks like a storage room, you know. So we've got 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16 villagers. We've got space for two more. But I'm saving up for the emeralds, for the library and the school. Um, This is one of my last most expensive purchase. This is the tavern. I've got four more bookshelves to place. I might put cobwebs or something in the library, but I don't know whether the AI would like that or not. So I've got the floor in that room to do. I've got test mine shelf is finished, so I have to move the token over here. And this one's finished, I think. And you can tell when they're finished by when you walk down the end, the border will be visible at the end. Or it would just go to ravine. That's good to know. Some of that to finish it iron for me. So I've got three beacons at the moment. I've got four beacons, but I can't afford the iron to place below the other one. It's not a bit. So yeah, I think this one goes up the length. Yeah, see? You can see, you can tell I'm near the edge because I do it all spectrally. See that? Get my hand. So this is the border. So yeah, what I've been doing is Yeah, so I always know that the mine's down here, which would be at the right level. The problem is that over here there's a ravine. And so I didn't want to. Have to like so we've recently updated to a new version and it's allowed the API the Tango uses to I think it works faster because it's not really an external jar, which is pretty cool. So we've got like we've got a tavern here. I'm gonna put some slabs around it to make it look better. I don't know whether this version allows me to put iron trapdoors around it and then put a larder in the middle. I don't know whether that will work or whether it will have a fit about it. I have to do the ceiling in this room, which looks a bit naff being the way it is. That'll be in the next episode, I think. Yeah, we've got the school done. We've got some animals from up top down here. We've got the cows and the sheep, but I need to get some chicken and some pigs. So what I like to do, I don't know whether other people like to do it too, but what I like to do is wireframe the different buildings, different structures, because so this here is the maximum size of a storage room you can get. This is the maximum size of just about of the inn of the tavern. So, and the less important rooms, like the butcher, which is the back one over there, is then I've just made it smaller. So this room here is a spare room. I'm not quite sure. I don't know whether I missed anything out, which is why there's that room here that I haven't done anything with. We've got. I made a point of having the beetroot, carrots, wheat. potato like this, because the chances of you getting seeds from beetroot, it can be really low in vanilla. But I don't know whether the rate for the rate for seeds is the same as if I did it, or whether it would be different. Preserve in mind, you can do what you like with the that kind of thing. For those wondering, I put these doors here, so if there was a zombie to got through those two doors, he would have to break these doors down as well. And I've got enough guards that it would make sense for people to run upstairs and rescue them. This took a very long time to clear out. I wasn't going to do a series on here, and if the comments on here aren't, on the comments in this video aren't very positive, I probably won't do another. But yeah, I find this kind of thing relaxing for a change. I will be uploading another couple of episodes of Craft Away soon. I'm hopefully moving house, so that's going to make things interesting for that regard. I do want to be able to get some sort of light in here so that things don't spawn. So things won't spawn on the stairs or the slabs, but they will be able to spawn where the saplings are. So I want to make sure the light level is high enough. I was going to use like lava with like glass on top, but that would just throw the chances of something happening too high. I am experiencing this happening. This happens when the villager cuts down this tree, and all the leaves attached to that tree will be cut down, and thus what happens is, I don't need this guy. This guy can go. Tyrone, you can go. So yeah, see, these leaves are touching. So when someone harvests either tree, the leaves of both of them can go, leaving one of them a stump. That's because the trees have fallen apart. But I knew that was likely to happen, so I don't know whether I should be planting these trees like in a pattern so that the leaves that they cut will be different, if that makes sense. So I've got this whole area pretty much to myself, me and my base mate. Oh, a nomad. Let's give him a job. As I was saying before I was interrupted. So I'm in the extreme hills. It's pretty cool because it means that all of this lovely terrain that I'm having to jump over is all mine. So this line where you see the torches marks the area of my town. Haven't quite marked out this one here yet, but because it's extreme hills, I'm pretty certain I can clear out like that hill was nowhere to go. So there, if you cross here, that water there will go. That goes to the tree farm area. So if I want to find, if I find a pig, that's where I'm gonna go. I'm gonna just buy some eggs from someone, I think. That's probably the easiest way to do it. Yeah, this goes to the, that's the floor of the of the tree farm. Is that all about? But yeah. I don't know whether to do the saplings pattern based upon different trees, whether that'll help speed up the despawn rate. If it does, then I'll probably end up doing. So basically they find some pigs. And so long as it's pathable from this water, I can get them back. Okay, I said pigs, but oh, I needed leather one day, that's what it was. So yeah, I'm going to be uploading this video since I've stopped recording it. So we're just like half the time tonight on here. Biggies! So we've got lots of trees. Slowly covering this up. put some sea lanterns in here to finish the floor. Going to be the butcher's room, I think I said that earlier. Those will probably all be grass. Probably be easier that way. So the school, the inn, the inn was 8 blocks of emeralds, which, yeah. A lot of money. Oh. Got one bed spare. So yeah, I'm going to get as many chests as I can to make it look reasonable. What do you got, a corridor of 3, I think? Yeah, that's what I'm going to do. This is a spare room, I'm not quite sure what rooms I haven't got planned out. What are you missing then? Okay, I've got the inn. School's planned, I haven't got enough emeralds for that one. Sheep and I've got pig pen, cow pen, chicken coop, library, butchers, and that's it. Oh, and a crap ton of houses. So you may be wondering, like, how long would it take me to empty out the area? So what I did is I dug down one from here, and that this is actually the ceiling. Look. course not. Over here. That's right, from over here. This is a good example, actually. Look at my bad terraforming skills. You can see that this wall here is the inside of the outside wall of the wood farm. I'll hopefully get someone to terraform that bit. I've done it like this to disable the necromancer. Yeah, up to here. This is my village. I'm trying to make sure that it's pathable from all the four corners. Obviously, apart from the one in the water, not two in the water. Because that way, the necromancer, like who decided to turn it on, will spawn up here and not down there on the ground. Just going to shade this off, and of course it's probably a pink cow, a black cow, sheep. I might do something. I might do something with the landscape. I wasn't planning on doing so, but I might, depends how I really. Let's actually plug up this water. So technically speaking, these trees within the town could be chopped down by my lumberjacks. Which I probably should put something underneath them, sort of from happening. But the way I think the AI works is it goes for the ones it can get to first. It won't chop down these 2x2s because they are. Too big for the algorithm. That's what I'm hoping for, at least. I'm hoping that's the case. To change that soon to get in proper houses. So I'm gonna put a ceiling on this place, I think. Sure, what we need to go with it. Need to plug up these holes so that things don't fall down. Seems to be absolutely no correlation as to where what goes where. So I might do because this is the like one block below that. This is the ceiling of the one above, which you can tell here. I'm obviously missing blocks here, but never mind. Let's see how we've got sugar cane. Oh, the enchanter. Meh. I'm starting to think spoiling in here. So we've got the sheep, cows, and yeah, pigs and chicken to go. This is already set up, really, waiting for the token. Doing it this way means that the height doesn't matter really, as long as the token, as long as the rooms aren't too tall, basically, I think. So here we've got loads of trees. Oak and jungle. Hey, Cyclotron. So yeah. So I just need to get carpet on here. Yep. I think everywhere. It's fine. Partly because I get hammered with the freelancers. Yeah, all fine. The only bit I haven't done it to is the farm area, because that's an awful lot of sea lanterns, and I can't afford that much. So yeah, tavern. Your wares all numbers here to be higher than 8. Just in case. Yeah. That's it for this episode. If you like what you see, then write in the comments, you know, I should continue doing the videos. But until next time, hopefully, I will see you soon. Bye bye.